You're scrolling, guys. It's Houston Sports Talk Record in the video today. And today, the Philadelphia 76ers beat the Boston Celtics in Game 4, 116-115 in overtime in the Eastern Conference semifinal, and tie the series up 2-2. And an amazing performance by James Harden and Joel Embiid combined it for 76 points in this game. Harden scoring 42. They had a huge lead in this game. I think they were up at 1.16. I think they were up 56-40-something in the first half. Boston came back, took a five-point lead in the fourth quarter. Philly came back, tied the game at 105. Then I think Boston took a 107-105 lead with some Tatum free throws. Harden was clutch to send the game to overtime with a layup, and that's when it went to overtime. Boston was really, Philly before that last Harden shot, that last three-pointer Harden shot, Philly had only led once in overtime, but then Boston's up 115-113 after a three by Tatum. Embiid made two free throws. Philly was up 113-112. That was the only time before the Harden three that Philly was up in overtime. And so Philly's up 113-112. Then Tatum hits a step-back three, which in my opinion I thought was an offensive foul by Tatum. I didn't think that Tyrese Maxey. I don't know. I thought – and I know, the commentators on the ESPN call, Mark Jones and – I forgot the other woman's name. Burke. Her last name's Burke. Both of them thought that it was offensive foul. Obviously, the Philly fans thought it was a foul as well. Me personally, I'm not a fan of either of these teams. I do like James Harden, but I do think that was a foul on Jason Tatum. But no call there. Tatum makes the three. It's a 115-113 game. Sixers try to go. The Sixers tried to get a play out, but they couldn't, and I think they called a timeout, and then or something happened, or there was a loose ball or something happened that would keep Philly would have the ball again. Harden drived and kicked it to Maxey, and it was out off Derek White, so Philly would inbound again. And that's where Embiid got double teamed, was going to step back. James said the play was Embiid was going to try to tie it with a fadeaway. I was in the corner to give Embiid some space, but Jaylen Brown left Harden a little open. They doubled Embiid, so Embiid kicked it to Harden, and that's where James Harden is in the corner and makes the wide open three. Jaylen Brown did come back on him after Harden got the ball. And Harden drills the three and get the 116-115 win. But I want to switch to non-basketball here. James Harden, not only was he the MVP of this game, but he was the MVP on the court of this game. But I think he was the MVP off the court as well. We saw it in February with the Michigan State shooting that left John, more known as John, was shot, and one of the survivors of Michigan State shooting, and in February, and he's also a big James Harden fan. I don't think now he's a Sixers fan, but he's mainly a big James Harden fan, and the word got to Harden in February, FaceTimed him, and gave him words of encouragement, told him everything was going to be okay, even though he just found out that he's never going to walk again, even though he did survive. And James Harden sent him a bunch of shoes and game worn shoes, signed shoes, just a crap ton of stuff that James sent to him. And he made a couple promises to him. He told John that he kind of didn't know when, but he told him that when you're healed and we're gonna figure out a game, and we're gonna get you down here, and we're gonna get you to a game. That was today. John was in attendance tonight or today, and But I want to continue to go, and then James also gave him his phone number, and told him he can FaceTime him whenever he said he can FaceTime him whenever he want. Well, I bet he could. But he told him that, you know, if he needs anything, all he has to do is ask, and that they'll FaceTime soon. And that was back in February. Today we found out that John was in attendance at Game 4, and earlier in the pregame, you can see James go hug John, and you know, talk with him a little bit. I think Harden kind of put his foot out to John's shoe because Harden could kind of recognize that John was wearing one of the shoes that Harden gave to him. I think you can kind of see that James is, you know, saying that there. And then I saw a TikTok right after the game was over. The first thing James said after it was over was said about three times, "Where's John?" And then he asked someone, he said, "Where's John? Where's John?" And then he asked someone else because he couldn't find it, "Where's John?" And he went straight to John after the game, was standing right beside him, and, you know, even, you know, was right next, John was right next to him when ESPN interviewed Harden after his 42 points. So just a W. That was just James Harden's awesome for that. And I could not talk about this game and not bring that up. But that's amazing there by James right there. And speaking, you know, talking about James and that whole story that he, you know, that whole amazing thing that James has done in the last couple of months with John. I think he did something with Gabe. He donated a bunch of stuff for treatment for John, I think, as well. But I think I did hear that. But first thing with stats, we're gonna start off with James Harden, since, you know, he was so awesome. He's been so awesome with John and stuff. But James was still the best player in this game. James had 42 points, 9 assists, 8 rebounds. We saw that game one Harden, and you kind of saw game one Harden with Embiid having almost 35 points as well. So you kind of didn't think James could score 40 with Embiid on the court, but the ball was in James' hand. I mean, the ball was still basically in Embiid's hands more. And I want to talk about, again, I talked about this on game one when I did my game one post game. Harden scored 45 in game one with only 4 free throws taken. He scored 42 tonight with only 4 free throws taken as well. I'm talking about, you know, Harden Houston days. If he's scoring 45 and 42, Harden, I don't know. I'm just saying it with the way Harden got fouls in Houston if Harden was taking free throws like he was in Houston, I personally think Harden might have. I think Harden could have possibly had around maybe, you know, 50 tonight with the free, if he was taking the free throws he used to take, and it's probably 60 on that game one. He's not taking that many free throws anymore. Only 4 for him tonight, but he was great besides scoring 9 assists, 8 rebounds, near triple double, four steals for James too. I mean, and one block. Always talked about how his defense was horrible. 4 steals and a block for James tonight. 16 for 23, 6 for 9. And honestly, I think he was the most clutch player for Philadelphia tonight, if you really look at it for them. I mean, he had the layup to tie the game and send it to overtime at 107. And then he hit the game three, the game-winning three. So Harden was amazing tonight when they needed him at the end of the fourth and the end of the overtime. Getting to Embiid, though, Embiid was amazing as well. 34 points, 13 rebounds, 4 assists, 1 steal, 11 for 26, 0 for 3 from 3, 12 for 15 from the free throw line. You see, Embiid's getting a bunch of free throws. Embiid is trying to draw fouls more. Other starters, Maxey had 14, weight and 8 rebounds and 8 rebounds and 2 steals. Way better impact than he's had in So he scored game one, Maxey had 26. Then combined game two and game three, he had 26. So, it's not as good as he did in game one, but they didn't have Embiid back then. And But it's a little bit better than he did in game two and in game three. So better impact by Maxey. 6 for 17, 2 for 6 from 3 for Maxey tonight. Tobias Harris with 9 points, 6 for PJ Tucker, and 3 rebounds and 1 assist. Only 2 scores off the bench for Philly in this game. Paul Reed with 2 points, and then 9 for Georgia Yang. D'Anthony Melton played 25 minutes in this one with 0 points, but 2 shots taken. He also had 2 assists and 2 rebounds. I'm going to go over Boston scoring real quick. Tatum had 24 and 18 rebounds and 6 assists and 4 blocks for Tatum tonight. Not a good scoring night for Tatum, but 18 rebounds, 4 blocks, and 6 assists, and 24 points. 23 for Jaylen Brown. He scored like 11 or 12 points in the first 5 minutes of the game. Got a little quiet after that. 10 for 16, 3 for 8 from 3. Jaylen Brown has 23. 21 for Marcus Smart. Could have had the game winner, but it was a 3-pointer to try to win it. Was just off. Ball went in the net, but they didn't, you know, manage the clock well. And Marcus Smart finishes with 21 and 7 assists, 6 for 15 from shooting, 6 for 15 from the floor, and 4 for 10 from 3, and 5 for 5 at the free throw line. 10 for Al Horford, and then final starter Derek White with 12. Then Malcolm Brogdon was amazing off the bench. 36 minutes tonight for him, 19 points, 6 for 13, 5 for 8 from 3, and 8 rebounds. And then 2 other scorers off the bench, Robert Williams with 4 points, 1 block, and 2 rebounds. And then Grant Williams in 12 minutes had 2 points. And that was it. DNP for Blake Griffin, Sam Hauser, who's been playing mostly in the playoffs, Mike Muscala, Luke Kurnett, and Peyton Pritchardson. Sixers DNPs, Jaden McDaniels, Daniel House Jr., Dwayne Dedman, Montrezl Harrell, Shake Milton, Korkmaz, and Jaden Springer. Great win for Philly. Great performance by Harden and Embiid. That's the video. Hope you guys enjoyed, and peace out. Let me know your thoughts on the game.